Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. So chapter 6 periodic table, and today is still on 6.2 periodicity, and we're going to focus on ionization energy and electronegativity. So at the end of this lesson, you should be able to define both first IE and also electronegativity and explain the variation of first IE across the period down the group as well as for electronegativity. So let's start with first ionization energy, ataupun first IE. It is the minimum energy required to remove 1 mole of electron from 1 mole of neutral gaseous atom. Okay, so kalau let's say kita ada X gas, okay, dia remove 1 electron, and dia akan jadi X plus ion dalam bentuk gas. Dan energi yang diperlukan untuk remove elektron ini adalah dipanggil sebagai first ionization energy. So value of first IE depends on the strength of attraction between nucleus and valence electron. Sebab first electron yang akan kena remove adalah valence electron. So semakin kuat attraction between nucleus and valence electron, it is harder to remove the electron. So more energy required to remove the electron, maka dia punya first IE akan semakin tinggi. Now let's have a look at the trend. So down the group, first IE decrease. Why? Because down the group, number of shell increase. Shielding effect also increase. Attraction between nucleus and valence electron semakin lemah kan, sebab semakin jauh. And then size of atom semakin besar. So bila size of atom semakin besar, maka distance between nucleus and valence electron semakin jauh. So bila semakin jauh, easier to remove electron. Bila easier to remove electron, maka less energy required to remove the electron. Maka first IE decrease. Now across the period, first IE increase. Why? Because across the period, proton number increase. ZEV increase. Attraction between nucleus and valence electron semakin kuat. Size of atom semakin kecil. Maka distance between nucleus and valence electron semakin kecil. So it is harder to remove electron. So more energy required to remove that electron. So first IE increased. Let's have a look at what is electronegativity. It is the relative tendency of an atom to attract electrons towards itself when chemically bonded to another atom. Contoh, kalau H dengan F kan, F lebih elektronegatif, jadi dia memang tarik elektron lebih kepada dia. Dan sama juga H dengan Cl, Cl lebih elektronegatif, so dia akan tarik elektron lebih kepada dia. Kau tengok kan, bukan di tengah-tengah tuh elektron, dia lebih kepada F dengan Cl. Tetapi kalau compare F dengan Cl pula, F lebih elektronegatif, sebab apa? Dia akan attract elektron lebih dekat dengan dia berbanding dengan Cl. So cerita dia, as size of atom increase, attraction between nucleus dan valence electron semakin lemah kan bila size besar. Jadi electronegativity semakin kurang. Dan sebaliknya, kalau size makin kecil, maka attraction makin kuat. Bila attraction makin kuat, maka tinggilah electronegativity. That is what happened across the period. Electronegativity increase. Down the group, disebabkan size semakin besar, maka electronegativity semakin kurang. So attraction semakin lemah. So here is the explanation. Down the group, electronegativity increase. Why? Number of shell increase. Shielding effect increase. Attraction between nucleus and valence electron weaker. So size of atom besar, maka electronegativity decrease. Dan across the period pula electronegativity increase. Why? Because proton number increase. ZEV increase. Attraction between nucleus semakin kuat sebab size semakin kecil kan. So electronegativity dia semakin besar, semakin tinggi. So tidak kisahlah period 2 or period 3, electronegativity akan increase across the period. From Li to fluorine dari period 2. Kalau period 3 pula, from Na to Cl. So both cases across the period increasing electronegativity. Now let's try this question. Which element has the higher first ionization energy? Explain. So A, Mg or Na. So dia punya cara adalah first kali apa-apa pun dalam chapter ni kan, buat electronic configuration dulu. So from this electronic configuration to Mg punya, and then Na 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. And then lepas kita sudah buat dia punya electronic configuration, we do the border again. Yes. And then di sini dapati bahawa Mg dia punya N equal to 3, Na also N equal to 3. So dia punya shell sama, so tidak boleh compare shell kan. So go to the next factor, which is ZEV. So ZEV, okay, Mg proton number dia 12. So 12 minus dengan dia punya inner electron ada 6 tambah 2 tambah 2, 10. So plus 2 dia punya ZEV. For Na, 11 minus 10. So positive 1 dia punya ZEV. So ZEV tidak sama kan? So Mg has bigger proton number than Na. So Mg has higher ZEV than Na. So bila ZEV lebih tinggi, so ini kita pakai faktor Pisas. Jadi kita sambung. So lepas P dengan ZEV, kita pakai. So Mg has stronger attraction between nucleus and valence electron compared to Na. So kesimpulannya, size of Mg lebih kecil daripada Na. So electron is harder to be removed
in Mg compared to Na. Hence, Mg has higher first IE compared to Na. Nah, untuk soalan B, sama juga kita compare O dengan S. So, kita buat dia punya electronic configuration for both elements. So, 1s2, 2s2, 2p4 untuk oksigen. And then untuk sulfur, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p4. Jadi, N equal to 2 untuk oksigen, and N equal to 3 untuk sulfur. So, from here kita tahu sudah, N untuk sulfur lebih besar. Jadi, bila N tinggi, maka Schilling effect pun tinggi. Bila Schilling effect tinggi, maka attraction between nucleus and valence electron semakin lemah. Jadi, size dia semakin besar. Kan, bila size of atom lebih besar, maka electron is easier to be removed from sulfur compared to Na. So, bila easier to remove electron in sulfur, that means less energy required. So, bila less energy required to remove electron in sulfur, maka sulfur has lower first IE compared to oxygen. So, jawapan untuk soalan ini adalah oxygen has higher first IE compared to sulfur. So, soalan minta siapa yang higher, kan? So, penjelasannya boleh pakai ENSAS. Now, try this to explain why the first IE decreases down the group in the periodic table. So, down the group, okay, number of shell increase. So, as number of shell increase, maka Schilling effect also increase. Bila Schilling effect increase, maka attraction between nucleus and valence electron akan semakin lemah, sebab jauh kan. So, size akan semakin besar. So, bila semakin besar size, okay, as the size increase, maka less energy required to remove electron. So, bila easier to remove electron, maka first IE akan semakin rendah. Dan sebenarnya kita sudah pakai faktor ENSAS. So, try these three. Indicate which element of each pair has the higher electronegativity. So, sama juga kunci dia. Buat dulu electronic configuration. Na, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. K ada 19. So, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1. Kita buat border macam biasa. And then kita akan dapati bahawa dia punya N untuk Na ada 3. N untuk potassium K ada 4. Jadi, Na is smaller than K. So, bila N is small, Na is smaller than K, Na has higher electronegativity compared to K. As simple as that. So, penjelasan lebih lanjut boleh refer kepada faktor ENSAS tadi. So, kesimpulan dia, size lebih besar, electronegativity akan semakin berkurang. And sebaliknya, vice versa. Size kalau kecil size, maka electronegativity semakin besar. So, for the rest of this question, since dia meminta high electronegativity, kita cari jelas siapa yang smaller size. And the answer is as follow. So, summary 4. 6.2 adalah, when size increase, first IE akan decrease. Sebab easier to remove electron. And electronegativity juga decrease sebab attraction semakin lemah. And of course, sebaliknya. So guys, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Thank you and stay tuned for the next video in chapter 7. Bye-bye.